Hello everyone, Rocco here. So I wanted to give you a little video on how to kill Ghost Spirit in just three cannon shots. So when you're killing the enemies on top of the ship, you want to be sure to save that last enemy so that you're standing next to that right cannon on the right side. It's the best cannon to do when you're going to shoot him three times. So when you kill the last enemy, that doesn't count the cannon skeletons. They don't actually count as enemies for some reason. It's any of the walking ones like the jug or the pistols or the bottle throwers. When you kill the last one of them, he'll start his little spiel, which is kind of like countdown until he spawns. So if you get on the cannon on the right side and you wait till he says the word treasure and then you light your cannon, you'll actually be able to hit him right in the center of the room right as he spawns. If you do it too early, the cannonball will actually fly right through him like he's a ghost, which I guess makes sense since his name is Ghostbeard. But if you do it at the right time, when he says treasure, like I'll show you in this video clip here, you'll actually be able to knock him down. This island with my treasure. So when you're planning that second shot, you want to make sure that it's kind of, you want to lead him a little bit because he wants to drift to that right side. So you want to make sure to lead him. And the way he stands up is based on where his feet are. So if his feet are over here, he stands up like this instead of like, he doesn't like float up and like go towards the center. He'll just kind of float up on his feet. That's kind of the rotation point. So if you can kind of predict that, it takes a lot of practice. But as you can see in some of these clips, I'm predicting where he's going to move and I hit him. You can use, since that cannon has that explosion value where you can hit enemies within a radius, you can actually shoot the gold stack, the gold pile in the middle of the room and it'll actually hit him, or you can hit the cardboard cutouts like the stalagmites and stuff, rocks hanging from the ceiling, and that'll actually do damage to him as well. And you want to get three shots in and you'll kill Ghostbeard, and then you actually don't have to fight him at all. He's not a threat anymore. Instead, you'll just hear him making weird ghostly noises from the ceiling as he spawns in more swashbucklers. But towards the end, he'll do his little ha ha ha, and then he'll die, and then you won the quest without actually having to face him. So it's just an easy way to kill him quickly and easily. So I had this little clip at the end because I was with Supremium and Molokov, and I was in the center, and Supremium was on the right side cannon, and I was using some flintlocks to shoot Ghostbeard, and it's some bizarre behavior, but for some reason when you shoot Ghostbeard with a flintlock, depending, this is obviously server dependent, but he was staying still for like an extra second, which allowed Supremium to get some of his shots off that he probably would have otherwise missed. And it's really bizarre to see. I mean, you can kind of see it from my point of view. You can see that he thanks me at the end, so I think it might have looked a little bit different on his screen. When I was shooting it, you can see that he's able to hit it all three times, where in other cases, I don't think he probably would have been able to hit it. He started like a little bit late on a hesitant, and it didn't quite seem like he was going to make it, but because I shot him, I think it actually held Ghostbeard there, like stuttered him there for long enough for him to get that cannonball to hit him, which is pretty cool. So it's just something to try. If you have teammates or a lot of friends that play it with you, you can definitely try that tactic. It's hard to get any randoms to do it, obviously. It takes a lot of teamwork and knowing what's going on to do it, but it's definitely fun and I highly recommend it. So thanks for watching, everyone. Due to the scoreboards being broken, we actually can't do any speedruns right now. So I figured I'd release some informational videos on what the best practices and strategies are for doing some of the quests. Crescendo will hopefully be my next one with the S+ rank. Do the scoreboard bug, you know, you can actually see that scoreboard, so I can kind of explain how that works. But thanks again. Sure to subscribe. I hope to post more videos in the future. See ya.